exploring how AI can elevate spiritual intelligence and personal well-being, but also help us formulate creative ideas beyond the current paradigm. So, exploring that, I asked the following question today. Can you formulate an argument that if the observer is non-local, then both Schrodinger and Schrodinger's cat are dead and alive at the same time in different domains of the universe? So here's what it came up with. Here's an argument for the hypothesis that a non-local observer would see Schrodinger's cat as both dead and alive in different domains of the multiverse. In quantum mechanics, entanglement allows the state of one particle to be correlated with another, even when separated by large distances. This suggests that a non-local observer could perceive multiple states of a system simultaneously. If we consider the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics, each possible outcome of a measurement branches off into its own universe or domain. So, from a non-local perspective, all possible states of Schrodinger's cat, both dead and alive, would exist in different domains of the multiverse. Additionally, if the observer is non-local and not bound by the constraints of special relativity, they could theoretically perceive these different branches of the multiverse simultaneously. This would allow them to see Schrodinger's cat as both alive and dead at the same time, but in different domains. Now, notice it only addressed Schrodinger's cat, not Schrodinger himself, even though I asked about that. So I pursued this argument. I said, I'd like you to elaborate further, not just about Schrodinger's cat, but Schrodinger himself. Because if Schrodinger and Schrodinger's cat are quantum entangled in the multiverse, then both of them, Schrodinger and the cat itself, would be dead and alive at the same time in different domains of the multiverse. So it finally got what I was asking. Took a little while. Erwin Schrödinger was an Austrian physicist who made major contributions to quantum theory in the early 20th century. He's best known for his thought experiment involving a cat in a box, which he used to illustrate the paradoxical implications of quantum superposition. In the thought experiment, a cat is placed in a sealed box with a radioactive source, poison, and a Geiger counter. If the radioactive source decays, it triggers the Geiger counter, which releases the poison, killing the cat. According to quantum mechanics, before the box is opened, the radioactive atom persists in a superposition of decayed and non-decayed states. This means that until observed, the cat is considered to be in a superposition of alive and dead states. Schrödinger argued that this idea of the cat being both alive and dead simultaneously was absurd. He did not actually believe the cat could be in a quantum superposition. Rather, he used the thought experiment to criticize the Copenhagen interpretation of quantum mechanics and the concept of wave function collapse. However, some interpretations of quantum mechanics, such as the many worlds interpretation, suggest that Schrödinger's cat could indeed be alive and dead in different branches of the multiverse. In this view, each possible outcome of a quantum event creates a new parallel universe. So when the box is opened, the universe splits into one where the cat is alive and one where it is dead. If Schrödinger himself was entangled with the cat in the box, then in some branches of multiverse, both Schrödinger and the cat would be alive. And while in others, both Schrödinger and the cat would be dead. This is because the observer becomes entangled with the observed system. So from a non-local perspective, Schrödinger and the cat would be seen as existing in a superposition of alive and dead states across the multiverse. So then it says, of course, the many worlds interpretation still remains controversial. I may add, by the way, that right now It's the most popular interpretation, even beyond the Copenhagen interpretation. I have a book here somewhere by Sean Carroll from then at Caltech. It's called Something Deeply Hidden, and it argues for the multiverse. So, what does this actually mean? If the non-local observer is without cause, non-local, without cause, infinite and divine, then of course you and I are alive and dead in different domains of the multiverse, and so is the cat or whatever else we observe as dead and alive at the same time. And this actually points to the deepest mystery. If that non-local observer is cosmic consciousness and omniscient, omnipresent, omnipotent, then of course you and I, and everything we observe simultaneously exists and doesn't exist in different domains of God's mind. Tell me what you think. I keep rambling, but I find it's fun.